Hello, everyone. Happy new week. The course just continues to fly by. I think I say that every semester, every year. It just goes so quickly. So congratulations. And just you're keeping on trucking, and it's all going to be done before we know it, which is unbelievable. This week, we are talking about quality improvement. I really enjoy this part of the course. The more and more I learn about quality improvement and more interaction I have with our students in our program, I realize what a valuable, I think I've always known it's valuable, but I guess I just see it growing more and more each year with the professionals that I engage with through the cohort and how important it is. And many times it is like so incredibly mandated and analyzed and broken down and built back up that it is just such a major part of what we do, no matter what our profession is. So I hope that this week you will really kind of be able to see how this plays into your role as a professional and some areas of strength that you have, as well as some areas that you can improve upon when it comes to thinking about quality improvement in the learning and facilitating and training environment that you work in. Okay, so our objectives for the week involve identifying key elements of data analysis and quality improvement with a specific focus on strategies and suggestions for analyzing data. We will also identify various theories, and I'm just going to kind of highlight a couple of those that impact quality improvement of curriculum. And in order to demonstrate learning, you will also process, explain your process of data collection and analysis through a personal post to the discussion board and responses to your peers. And then, of course, we will be talking about the CAI final project so that you will kind of indicate kind of what you're thinking about that as well, so I can see you starting to apply the knowledge that we talk about this week. So with our quality improvement, the best definition I found, and I can't even remember where I saw it, but was a formal scientific approach to the analysis of performance and systematic efforts to improve it. It's just something I have written down. I don't know why I didn't give my source, but I just really liked that quote. So I think it is really important that this week we kind of think of ourselves in more formal scientific ways, because we just got done talking about assessment. And in essence, quality improvement is assessment. But what I want you to do is I want you to kind of right now see the two pieces a little bit differently. When we use assessment in our teaching and our facilitating, we may have pre-assessments, we may have formative assessments, we may have major projects, we may have some summative evaluations, you know, that whole assessment as, assessment for, and assessment of learning, okay? Those are pieces of our curriculum, our training, our facilitation, all right? But then what we need to do is we need to step back and we need to look at it big picture. So all of what I'm doing, all of these assessments, the curricular decisions that I make, the instructional decisions that I make, my quality improvement then is going to make sure that all of that is meeting the goals and objectives that we have set forth. So when we talked about curriculum, we talked about outcomes, we talked about objectives, and we need to make sure that all this body that I have right here, that these things are moving our learners forward, our team members forward, and that they are meeting the outcomes, objectives, goals that we have set for them, okay? And so quality improvement is going to allow us to assess our progress. Now, that doesn't mean to say we won't use data from a pre-assessment, we won't use data from a summative assessment, and we won't use data from a formative assessment. I'm not saying that at all. That's where they then kind of combine, okay? And they can, and maybe they won't at all. They likely will, but maybe they won't. And so that's what I really want you to think about this week. So what I have done, and you'll see from my voiceover presentation as well as what you read, again, you could devote a whole course to this. There's so much good stuff out there. thinking about quality improvement and the theory behind that. And so I have included a couple of things. I've included Six Sigma because I know that's a big one in our business industry. I don't know a whole lot about it, but maybe there are a couple of you out there who are experts on it. I have included the PSDA, the Deming cycle, which I really like because it's pretty self-explanatory, and it just makes sense to plan, do, study, act. So we plan how we're going to evaluate our program, how we're going to evaluate our curriculum. We do. We execute the plan, taking small steps in controlled circumstances. Then we study. So these tiny steps, we took whatever assessment data it was we were going to collect, whatever informal data it was we were going to collect, whatever bigger picture program data that we were going to collect. We check and study those results, and then we take action based on those results, okay? And so that can be just a tiny circle, something you do. Let's say you're an instructor and something that you teach every semester, you pick one area that you're going to look at each semester and you do that PDSA. But maybe it's a bigger picture thing too. And again, that will depend on your CAI final project. If you are creating a whole new curriculum, a whole new program, then your quality improvement is going to be much bigger. Whereas if you are designing a new course, that quality improvement, if you choose to kind of use the theory of the Deming cycle behind it, it's going to be a little bit smaller. And that is totally okay, as long as we are using some kind of theory to support what it is that you're doing to keep your program, your course, your project, your training in check. Another one that I included, which I absolutely love in education, is the multiple measurings by Victoria Bernhardt, the multiple measures of data. And I've got a really great chart. And it's not so much that I love, like, I just love her idea behind it of really looking at how all of these different areas can impact each other. And you'll see what I'm talking about when you read or when you listen and read over her information. But she just does have so many great ideas about the impact that, you know, student demographics and student learning, if we look at those two paths and how they cross, what can that information tell us? And then let's see here. I have a couple others listed. Those are the main ones that I think I've actually provided some research on and just some information to support what we talk about. The articles, A Model for Curricular Assessment and Improvement, I think is a really good one that I've asked you to read for this week. And then there's another pharmaceutical one. I have so many papers. And where I can't find that one right now. But that is another good one that just really talks about that overall quality improvement. So again, whatever you can get to, whether it's in strand A or B or both, you know, if there's other stuff that you want to kind of print off and save for later, I think that would be a great idea too. So remembering that we will soon, next week, be moving into that CAI final project. And so please just remember, as you're going through this theory and you're thinking about what does quality improvement look like, pick one that you think will fit in with what it is you want to do with your CAI final project and how you want to evaluate and make sure that whether it's your course, your training, it's a program, it's a training program, it's a department program, you know, whatever it is, how are you going to keep making sure that there is quality, that you are improving, and that everything is moving forward like it's supposed to. So if you have any questions about that at all, please let me know, and we'll start to talk about that in the discussion board. So I'll be able to give you some feedback in that way too. But then next week, definitely, as we start moving forward with the outline of our CAI final project, I definitely will do my due diligence to make sure that you have a quality improvement plan in place. And also, I do understand that your institution or your place of work may already have their own kind of quality improvement plan in place. And so what I would just ask is that you are more than welcome to use that. but I would ask you to use theory to support that choice, okay? And when I hold office hours, we'll be able to have those kind of conversations, or of course, you know, you can call me anytime as well, and we can talk about those things too. So have a wonderful week, and let me know if you have any questions or comments. Okay, take care.